A very good morning to all. I cordially welcome our respected chairman, Mr. L. Devadas Samuel, and a beloved correspondent, Mrs. Paki Jyothi Devadas, the esteemed chief guest, Dr. P. Madhavan Rajkumar, our board members, principal, Mr. Prem Kumar, staffs, dear students, parents, our well-wishers to a virtual investiture ceremony for this academic year 2020-2021. We are happy to conduct a virtual investiture ceremony. So let's begin.
I, the principal of Commerce Matriculation Higher Secondary School, extremely happy to announce the school council members for the academic year 2020-21. School council members are school people leader Ms. Angelina Gladys of Standard 12, assistant school people leader Master Muhammad Ismail of Standard 11, sports secretary for the academic year 2020-21, Master Zianard Lobos Nicholson of Standard 11, assistant sports secretary Master Lebanon Kirubai of Standard 10, discipline secretary Ms. Sridevi of Standard 10, health secretary Master Dinesh of Standard 11, choir secretary Master Cornelius John of Standard 10, assistant choir secretary Miss Cindy of Standard 10, fine art secretary Miss Divya of Standard 10. We have four groups in our school by name: tulips, bluebells, zinnia and daffodils. Let me introduce the captain of each group. Tulips captain, Miss Sharon Divini Sadhana of Standard 11. Bluebells captain, Master Lok Ranjit of Standard 11. Zinnia captain, Master Balamurugan of Standard 11. Daffodils captain, Master Tarun of Standard 11. Leaders don't create followers, they create more leaders. Leadership is the capacity to translate vision. The ability to learn is the most important quality of a leader can have. With these fine quotes, I wish all the leaders to take up their responsibilities to complete everything in the best possible way. Thank you.
Fellow students, and set an example in all aspects of school life. Uphold and encourage all students to follow school rules and expectations. The great power comes from great responsibility. So, I'll actively take part in school activities and endeavor to bring laurels and glory to my school. I thank the management for giving this opportunity to me. Thank you.
Good morning to everyone. As a sports secretary of Carmel's Matriculation Higher Secondary School, I, Zionar Lobos Nicholson, pledge that I will set the stage for the betterment of sports in our school. I will encourage all the students to participate in all upcoming events and bring laurel to our school. Thank you.
Tulips are known for their bright, bold colors and beautiful shape. Red tulip represents passion and dedication. I, Sharon Divini Sadhana of Standard 11th, leader of the tulips group, pledge that I will lead my team members to achieve victory by their boldness, sincerity and dedication. As a team, we will work hard to achieve victory in all the events and bring laurels to the school. Thank you.
Good morning to everybody. Bluebells. Bluebell flowers are some of the most lovely you can behold. Usually, bluebell flowers symbolize gratitude and humanity. However, they can also symbolize contentment and everlasting love. I, Lok Ranjit of Standard 11, leader of Bluebells group, determined to lead my team to reach perfection and bloom like a sweet bluebell. I will do my best to bring out the talent of my team members in sports. Thank you for this opportunity.
Zinnia is a symbol of endurance because it blooms from midsummer all the way until frost. They are usually given to people who need to resolve major problems. Zinnia also symbolizes lasting friendship, goodness and remembrance. I, Balamuran P of Standard 11, promises to do my best to lead my team towards success. Thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity.
Daffodils. The daffodil is a yellow flower which symbols rebirth and new beginning. The color yellow is associated with joy, happiness, intellect, and energy. I, in Tarun of Standard 11, captain of the Daffodils, promise that I will surely work with my team towards active workers. Thank you.
Good morning, my dear students, my dear teachers, and my dear parents. Really, I feel so happy and proud to stand before you to congratulate our newly elected leaders. This is a wonderful opportunity which God has given to our lovely children to take up this leadership and be more responsible and diligent in their work. Yes, if we just look around us, such a pandemic situation, everywhere we hear some cries and lots of turmoils and tribulations going around. But God has blessed our Carmelites with this investiture ceremony to bring out new leaders for this new academic year 2020-21. I'm so happy to see these leaders taking up their oaths and they are going to ride fast to prove themselves as great leaders. Yes, a leader is a great thinker. A leader has great passion. A leader is a role model. A leader is one who has inspiration and motivates others. A leader is a one who empowers, the students for the betterment in their life. I'm really happy to have this rare opportunity of getting this leadership for these children. And children, you should never forget that God has given you a rare opportunity to become a leader. And this should really build a great confidence in your mind, softness in your heart, and kindness towards your fellow students. I'm really happy that you will be achieving these goals in the near future. As you know, the destiny of India lies in the classroom, said by Nehru. Yes, when you start your training as a leader in the classroom, you're training yourselves to become a great statesman of India. You will really feel proud that if you get your training in the classroom, in future, you will really be diligent, hardworking, and disciplining the society and many, many things more. Yes, God has chosen you to be a leader. God has given you the blessing to prove yourself that your leadership role will do great things in society. That's why you are chosen here to be trained. So children, don't take it very casually. Really be serious and just thank God for selecting you as a leader and start empowering all the students. And through that, you're going to empower the society. And through that, you are going to become a great leader for this nation, our India. So children, start working with passion. Start disciplining yourself for a diligent work. And as you know, Mahatma Gandhi was a great leader. Jawaharlal Nehru was a great leader. Yeah. So children, start working with passion. Start disciplining yourself for a diligent work. And as you know, Mahatma Gandhi was a great leader. Jawaharlal Nehru was a great leader. And you can think about many, many people and let this leadership role bring out the best from you and do a selfless work among the students. so that you can be a role model and you can be an inspiring person. Just be a motivator so that people will join with you, students will join with you to prove your leadership. Yes, I know, Carmelites will become great leaders. Carmelites will submit themselves to become great leaders, and they will dedicate all their talents with their mind, body and soul to become great leaders. And I know you are going to become great, and I wish you that your leadership, your responsibility as leader, as leaders, will do an yeoman service, not only to the school, to the society and for the future India. So congratulations, my children. I really feel proud and be happy to see you as a leader. Thank you.
Change is good, I won't let you down. I'll create an electric shock.
Dear children, a warm welcome and good morning to all. Happy Independence Day. Today, I want to share some thoughts about leadership. I thank God Almighty for this wonderful opportunity to interact with you. What is leadership? Leadership is the art of motivating a group of people to act towards achieving a common goal. Any art can be learned by practice. So leadership can be learned by practice. Just look into the elements. Motivating a group of people and the other parties for the achievement of a common goal. So leadership is nothing but motivating for achievement. Let us see some of the qualities of a good leader. Vision. A leader should have a vision, and that vision must be communicated to the people. Vision is the goal, the aim, or the end result expected. Everybody should have their own goals and aims. A leader should be able to communicate their vision to their followers. The second one is achievement. A leader should make others to achieve the goals. How is it possible? Making others to achieve. It is by inspiring and motivating. Inspiration involves changing the way the people think and feel about themselves so that they want to take positive actions. It is changing the mind of the people, the attitude of the people, the willingness of the people. Motivation is about moving people to act in such a way that achieves a specified goal. The third one is delegation and empowerment. A leader should delegate and empower others. Delegation is about entrusting someone else to do your job. It is allocation of power to subordinates. The next one is role model. A leader must be a role model to all his followers. The leader should be able to perform the role of a lowest cadre. It is the model for humbleness. Every leader should be a role model in all aspects with regard to his followers. A person looked to by others as an example to be imitated is role model. Let us see some of the model leaders. One is Moses from the Bible. Moses was a great leader who guided more than 20 lakhs of people. They traveled for more than 40 years through the desert. He delegated the power by forming an organizational structure and communicational protocol. The other one is Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation. He had a great vision. What is his vision? It is an independent India. He was able to communicate his vision to the people. He inspired the people. He motivated the people. He was able to achieve the goal through the people. He was a good leader, and he is a good model. And the ultimate leader, that is Jesus Christ. He inspired people, educated and empowered them. He conveyed the vision of loving one another. His followers are still preaching the good news of God's love to mankind. Let us all develop the leadership skills and be a good leader in the world around us. God bless you.
Saying thank you is more than good manners. It is good spirituality. Gratitude is not only the greatest of virtues, but the parent of all others. Good morning to all. It is a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this memorable occasion. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion a resounding success. First and foremost, I thank our special guest, Dr. P. Madhavan Rajkumar, a board member, one who shared his wonderful thoughts on leadership. We are always grateful to our chairman, Mr. L. Devadas Samuel, and our correspondent, Mrs. Pakya Jyoti Devadas, for their words of encouragement and constant support in each and every occasion. My heartfelt thanks goes to our staff, parents, and dear lovely students of Carmel's group of schools. Once again, I thank each and every one of you. Thank you.